miserably. Or that character. So let's beat the game to prove that I can do it. Go. Come on. Money, 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 money. Do you have enough? Nope, just shy. Sticky trail. So he does a lot of percentage damage. I don't actually have to stick around and watch people die. That's nice. I don't actually need money now to open chests. I can just open them as I come across them. It'll open everything on the screen. But yeah, so now I can just kind of hit people with that toxic thing. He has melee, which can be bad, but he's got like a stun attack that's kind of ranged. He's not a character you start out with. But if I had been playing, I would have unlocked him if I hadn't already had him unlocked. So maybe technically it's fair game? I don't know, at this point in time I just feel like I want to, you know, beat it to prove, to see the end of the game and all that jazz. I'm clearly not going to cut it as the commando. Which I'm always surprised that the speedrunner's like, oh, he's the best, because I clearly playing him wrong. Because I kind of think he sucks. Okay. So I'm just going to run around, because standing in one spot no longer works. I used to just kind of camp the end. Wow. That doesn't work anymore? Because the game's decided that it likes having tons and tons of people. Yes, stand on my poison. Maybe you can see why I prefer this. I want that. That was a very nice trade. Whoops, whoops, whoops. Oh, crud. Ah, dang it. Not ideal. There's that guy. Walk on my trail, get infected, die. All in a day's work. I hate you. I hate you a lot. A lot. Die, darn it. Now let's make my way back to the exit. Stand in my goo. They're both below me. Wait, maybe I don't need to go after them. Nope, I need to go after one of them. Someone missed the memo. No, I don't want that. No, I don't want that either. So I'm no longer going to be doing a lot of attacking, I'm just kind of going to lay down my goo thing and run. And use my goo thing to run. So my melee is not really terribly useful. I mean, I can mow down a boss, but I'm not going to be using that against the final boss. I'm just going to be running away from him and kind of spitting at him from afar like that. And I'm going to want those cooldowns back, like, immediately. But, so far things have gone a lot easier. For some reason the game just hates the commando, maybe. At least that's the way it feels. Anything over here? No. No, I can't afford any of that. Might as well just leave it. The advantage is I can, like, you know, leave a trail and still hurt the people chasing me. There's another character, the Huntress, that can, like, attack while moving, and that's pretty freaking awesome.
But,
yeah, I'm pretty confident I can beat the game with Akrid here. Okay. Who am I up against? Magma Worm. I must have missed. Yeah. Akrid's a bit harder because he doesn't get that nice invincibility roll that made surviving as a commando pretty easy to do. There we go. How's that not hitting him? I got him the very first time with it. Sure. That's beginning to hurt. Gotcha. Pass it on. Just like measles. Pass it to the neighbor next to you. And you'll never have to see him again. Ever. Well, you know, if it kills him. Which I guess technically be, you know, bioterrorism if you're doing that on purpose. But hey, you know, murder's in the details, right? Take that, go back down. Oh, I shot over all of their heads. Really? That's kind of impressive. Okay, this guy needs to get off the bouncy plan. Come on. Die. Two more. And I missed them both. Okay. Well, I might as well use up the money. Like I said, I'm pretty confident levels aren't worth it. Well, that's not all bad, actually. So the dice thing makes me do... I gain a chance to do a critical strike for that every time one of those things fails. So that actually works out nicely. A lot of things up here in the upper left. Yes, that's very good. I don't mind staying up here because that's where all the stuff is. And he can stay down there. That worked out super nicely. It's all about forcing people to fight on my poisonous goo. And passing the disease to all their friends. That's kind of where he gets all his strength from, is delayed damage. not the most intense gameplay, but pays off. I also feel like he's tougher for some reason. Which probably has no truth behind it, but, you know. Makes me feel better. Pass it on, pass it on. Now, I hate you. Eat colorful clown blobs. Ah, well, yes, and no. At least my critical chance. Well, I'm not actually meleeing people, so I suppose I don't really care about that. More important for me to gain a useful item like infusion, which will give me tons and tons of hit points, hopefully, by the time I reach that one dude. Okay. Come on. Come on. Ow, I don't like being zapped. Not cool. Not cool, bro. Not cool. Yeah, look at me destroy the boss. There we go. Drop a poison trap at low health. Die. 634. Is there anything immediately nearby? No, it's just more money. Okay. Well, 660 down the drain. That's the downside to not wandering around more. Now, well, I can do okay against the dude that lobs across the whole map. The Smelter. Or whatever his name is. I want the birds to die. I should have checked. Is the thing over there? No. No. No, it is not. I'm a biohazard. Please die. Nope, nothing down there for me. Oh, he teleported just as I throw the thing at him. Of course. Like a true jerk. Oh, it's above me. Okay, so let's see if I have to fight my least favorite friend. Yep, the cremator. The worst boss the game has. I mean, even the final boss, like, he doesn't shoot you from all the way across the map with attacks that do, you know, big chunks of your health. Jerk. Not good, 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 not good. Oh, man. And that really sucks because I don't have an option. I have to go down to fight with him. I don't know what to do. I'm probably gonna die.